Hello! This week's video is all about how to care for masks and keep them hygienic. So at the start of the month I did my first vlogging with Cold Urticaria video of the year and I promised to tell you more about my winter prep. I'm very aware that I went off on a tangent and just went for a walk. So, a big part of my winter prep is mask hygiene and keeping them clean for the next year, and this is just how I do that, and I'm also going to give you some tips on how to keep them clean throughout the year. First up, let's just get on with the big wash. The big wash. I said I was going to take you with me to do this, but then I needed masks and they needed a wash. And I couldn't film at the time, so I just went ahead and did it without you. Sorry, but there's not much to see. So here's my bag of masks. Look at them all. I haven't put them away yet, obviously. What I did, very simply, was I threw them in the washing machine on the 90 degree cycle or the boil wash, just masks. There's a lot of them, so I can kind of get away with doing that. And just let that run. Just with my normal detergent that I use for all of my clothes, nothing particularly special. A little bit of fabric softener because I like the smell. And then I tumble dried them all immediately and then they're all clean and dry. That's really it. There isn't really anything special that I do to them. I only just do that wash once a year. But that doesn't mean that I don't wash my masks throughout the year. Ordinarily, I just throw them in with my normal clothes wash, which is a 40-minute, 1-hour cycle. It is just the easiest and most efficient way to do it, because I don't go through that many masks in a week or 2 weeks or however long it is between laundry cycles. So I just chuck them in. Sometimes I tumble dry them, sometimes I air dry them. It really depends on how much I have in the load at the time. And that's kind of it wash-wise. They just in with my normal washing and I wear them sensibly. How do I know it's time to do a big wash? Well, you know when things get quite heavily used and they have been washed and they are perfectly clean and very hygienic, but they start to cling on to the laundry smell or the ever so slightly damp smell from perhaps they haven't dried all the way when you put them away. That smell. A lot of my masks were starting to really smell quite strongly of that, so while they were clean, they were just holding on to that. And my big boil wash gets rid of all that smell, so they're all nice and clean and fresh, and they smell very pleasant. So that's sort of when I know it's time to give them a big wash. But I will do a big wash regardless, usually right as we're going into winter, because that's when I'm going to start using my masks more heavily, because, hello if you're new here, I have a condition called cold urticaria, which basically means that I'm allergic to cold. I'll put another video up here, but the masks stop me from breathing in cold air and having an allergic reaction in my throat and in my lungs. So I've been wearing masks for just over 3 years now, and it has nothing really to do with COVID, but I do stick to my local COVID regulations because I am sensible, and it is no skin off my nose to continue wearing a mask inside when I was already wearing one. So that's how I wash my masks. There's really nothing fancy in that. I just have had that question, and I think it's worth saying if you are planning to continue wearing masks for the long term. Outside of washing, what do I do to keep my masks clean? Well, I change them regularly. How often should I change my mask? Well, I don't know if anyone else heard the horror stories or the anti-mask propaganda of I had a chest infection because I wore a mask. Yeah, that's because you wore the same cotton mask for like 2 or 3 weeks straight without washing it, or you reused a single-use mask for about a week. That is not the mask's fault. That is simply poor hygiene. Don't do that. Change your masks regularly. What do I mean by regularly? Well, if I have been out in a day and I've been wearing my mask around, say I've gone for a long walk around the park. So when I filmed my vlogging with cold urticaria video, the start of the month, I didn't reuse that mask. I kept it on while I was out, and then when I got home, I took it off and put it in the laundry. Because that's long enough. Because when you're breathing water vapor and anything in your mouth, you exhale. It gets damp. That's just how it works. If a mask has been worn long enough to get even a little bit damp, don't put it on again. Just get a fresh one. Things like if I just go for a quick trip to the co-op, which is a 5-minute walk up the road, I go and buy some snacks and then I come back, I might reuse that one. It's up to you and it's a judgment call, but usually one mask lasts for about one day, unless I have gone and run a very quick errand, and then I can probably wear it again the next day for another quick errand. If I'm going to be walking out for a long time, I will just get a fresh mask. And as you've seen, I have quite the collection, so I'm very much privileged in the fact that, like, I can do that. I know people that still have a rotation of about 5 masks, so they might not be able to just get a fresh one. I really would urge you, if you're going to continue wearing masks and if you want to practice good mask hygiene, perhaps get some more. You can get them really cheap, or have a stash of single-use masks for when all of your masks are dirty. Don't wear a dirty mask. Things like exercising. I do exercise in a mask if I'm exercising outside, but if I'm inside, I don't wear a mask, simply because my lungs will be angry with me. I actually made a video about exercising while wearing a mask, which I'll also link to up there. When I'm exercising like that, I take masks with me and I swap it out for the return journey, because I cycle sometimes. I haven't for like all of 2021 for some reason, but when I get back on the bike for my return journey, it will be a fresh mask, because it just gets damp. Keeping a clean face will really help you keep a clean mask. So those like mid-length errands, maybe like half an hour of mask wearing, where you don't feel like you need to have a fresh mask for the next errand, if you wash your face in between, that will really help you. Just keeping this clean, because if this is dirty, you're going to put this dirt on the inside of your mask, then you're going to take that off and it's going to be probably damp from you wearing it, and you're going to have that layer of dirt. That doesn't scream good hygiene to me. That is a perfect breeding ground for bacteria. So wash face, change masks regularly and sensibly. I did also another one. I made a video about skincare in masks, which I will put a link to up here, but essentially it's just me washing my face. And I used a jelly face mask in that video. I no longer have one of those because they stopped making them. But just, you know, facial skincare for me now is self-care. It's a self-care activity. I like having the fancy things from Lush that smell good and feel good when I put them on my face, but literally just wiping it over with a wet wipe will probably do, depending how dirty the face is. If I have been in full drag all day, a wet wipe probably isn't going to cut it. No heavy makeup in a cotton face mask, because it will stain. Okay, well, in very sad news, I appear to have lost my very favourite mask. But I made the mistake of wearing dark red lipstick and then putting the mask on because I had to, and it all rubbed off on the inside. So if you wear foundation, maybe consider having a single-use mask or a face shield. No heavy makeup, clean face, clean mask, change them regularly, and keep on top of annual maintenance or maintenance when needed. Those are my top tips for mask hygiene. This has probably been a really long and drawn out video because I realized I could have summed up in like 2 minutes. So I dragged out, sorry. So don't forget to like this video, drop a comment down below if you have any additional mask hygiene or mask care related tips. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 p.m. UK time, with at least one bonus video every single month. See you.